What is going on, guys? Today's going to be a fun one. We've got biceps, triceps on the menu. One thing that you cannot deny is having a pumped set of arms, you know, filling out your t-shirt. And today, I'm going to be teaching you all the techniques, exercise recommendations to be hitting your arms in completely different angles to make sure you get the absolute most out of your workout. The goal of your training is to understand the anatomy. First of all, with your biceps, you've got a short head on a long head, so there's two heads of your bicep. And with your triceps, you've got three heads, short, medial, and long head, okay? And each angle that you do will target the area slightly different. The thing is with your arms, they only activate in one plane of motion, which is elbow flexion, really. So for example, with your biceps, in order to target them, what I would always recommend, one exercise with your arms slightly in front of your shoulders, maybe hands behind your shoulders, and then maybe another one in a hammer grip. And then with your triceps, push down and overhead, and maybe one where you're bringing your hands behind your body. This way you should target all heads, you will maximize your gains. Okay, so firstly, the way to structure your workout, it all depends on, number one, your current workout split. So if you are training like 3 days a week, so you can probably get your biceps at the end of a pull session, your triceps at the end of a push session. Or if you feel like your arms are a weak point, you can do them on a separate day. Today, we're gonna be doing them as a superset, so biceps and triceps, just so we can get that maximum pump. Okay, so first of all, we're gonna be starting on our biceps. This exercise, with your hands in front of your shoulders, we're gonna go for a dumbbell preacher curl. The rep range that I usually like to go for, I tend to go for a higher rep. Reason being, I feel like it saves my joints. So anything between, say, 10 and 16 reps, I prefer keeping it in the double digit range. I find that I don't affect my wrists and my elbows, and I can do this for, I always think about longevity with any workout that I do, and those numbers feel good for me. Okay, so the goal with any body part, especially if they're lagging, is to strip the exercise right back. First of all, your form. Make sure that your technique is right. You don't need to worry about lifting too heavy for now. Focus on trying to feel the muscle working, okay? Stick to a tempo. Take that muscle through full range of motion and contract as hard as I can. A teaching point on my biceps, what I always like to say is try and squeeze the crease in your arms as hard as you can, and then on the way down, maybe try and flex your tricep. Do that for every rep and tell me how it feels. Next one, another bicep exercise where your hands are behind your body. We're gonna go for an incline bench dumbbell curl. The incline, depending on your flexibility, you can either go one down on the bench. I personally prefer just going a little bit more upright, and I just focus on sticking my chest up a bit more just so I can feel that stretch. So here, sitting back, pin your arms into your sides, keep your elbows back, and then curl up. Same teaching points as I've given you. Squeeze, full extension on the way down. What equipment you use is all down to preference. You can even use dumbbells, a straight bar, or you can even use an easy bar. Today we're gonna be doing using the dumbbells. So chest over the bench, hands in front of your shoulders, and then curling up. Again, try and squeeze the crease in your arms as hard as you can. Okay, you get most of the tension with this exercise at the top of the rep. And always focus on controlling it. You wanna try and make sure that the dumbbells don't swing back on the way down. And again with the reps, double digits, anything between say 10 and 16. With these, I like to just pinch and hold the weight at the top of the rep. Hold them nice and still and then control it on the way down. Right, so the next exercise where your hands are behind your shoulders is a low cable curl. great exercise because you stepping forward automatically pulls your hands right behind your body. You don't have to do any of the work other than just keeping your arms pinned into your sides. Okay, so arms in, curling up. You want to try and minimize any movement from the shoulders and then allow the cables to pull you right back. Keep pinching inwards and try and make it hurt as much as you can. Okay, with these isolation movements, you have to try and go through as much pain as possible and then push through that. That's where the progress comes. And with this movement, if there is a point where you do hit failure, you can step back to reduce some of the tension on the cable and then continue to extend your set. Always double digits with your reps, especially on this as well. All right, last movement for your buyers. I always, as I said, recommend a hammer grip. What this does actually helps with that thickness of the arm. Reason why I say that is all because if you actually look the way your arms hang, they're always naturally by the sides here. So if you can develop that angle of your arms, they should technically look bigger, okay? We're gonna choose a dumbbell hammer curl. I'm feeling strong today, so we're just gonna keep it old school and go for some alternating actually. We'll go for some alternating curls. You can go a little bit heavier doing these, and what this does, it gives your other arm a chance to rest the touch when you're doing it. So you lifting that weight, it doesn't seem so much, okay? So, right, what's heavy, man? What should we say? 10, 6s, 8s, 13, 30s, 30s, 30s. 3-0. Fuck me.
Zero.
Yeah? Second hammer grip exercise we're gonna do is a rope cable curl. This is a staple for me. I add this one into my routine all the time. Number one, I like to keep the reps actually quite high. I usually push for 20 reps on this. And I don't really keep myself too strict to the form. Number one, because it's on a cable, you're not really gonna hurt yourself. And the reps that I'm doing. So I really just try and hurt myself in this movement and just go for it, okay? So, arms pinned into your sides, grip hard and try your best to just keep the reps unbroken. I'm going through the motions, but still, I'm squeezing at the top of the rep as hard as I can. Fucking good exercise. Right, now move on to our triceps. If your goal is to fill out the sleeves of your t-shirt, then it's important that you don't forget or neglect your triceps because they are the largest part of your arm and it will help speed up the process. Or if you cannot be bothered to do that, just get a small t-shirt and then it will do the job. Exercise that I'm gonna go through today is I think this is called a Swiss bar, close grip press. I will add this exercise in if I'm doing my arms on a separate day on their own. If I am doing them on an end of a push workout, I probably wouldn't do this and I would just rely on my isolation movements. Only reason being because your triceps will probably get a lot of work through your big pushing exercises. So this will probably be a bit of overkill, but because we're fresh, we haven't done anything else and we're just doing arms today, we're gonna add this bad boy in. Because we are doing a big exercise, I will probably actually keep the reps relatively lower on this, something between say six and 10, okay? I think anything more than that is a bit too much. And obviously you wanna try and do a few warm-up sets, gradually building yourself up until you get to your working weight. Right, because this is a compound exercise means that you're working more than one muscle group. Other muscles are gonna come into play. So with this, your chest will work a touch, so will your shoulders. But because of the angle and grip that we are holding the bar, I'm holding it about shoulder width apart. It does put a bit more emphasis on those triceps. Substitute for your closed-grip press, you can just go for a cable, straight down, push down. Here I'm using a EZ bar, hands right to the corner for me. Elbows pinned in, I like to drop my forward slightly and then push the bar down to my toes, not my legs. And here you're gonna try and minimize any shoulder movement as much as you can. There is gonna be a point with any exercise you do where your form does slightly go, but obviously you wanna try and reduce that as much as possible. Right, next tricep exercise, we're gonna be working on the overhead part of the movement. Okay, my flexibility. The overhead part of the movement. I prefer to choose a dumbbell overhead lane over an extension. A lot of people either do these or an EZ bar or barbell skull crusher. I find with the skull crusher that it puts a lot of tension on my elbows and my wrists because of the rotation. I'm not as mobile, so I prefer to keep it in a neutral grip. And I find with a lot of people, they do prefer to do that as well, and they don't get as much strain on their elbows and wrists. So here, teacher points, laying back, start position up, and slightly back behind your shoulders. So you want your hands to be slightly behind your shoulders, move back on the bench, and get that stretch right behind your ears here, and then squeeze. Okay, so I usually like to control the weight on the way down for 2 seconds, and then pause at the top just for one, and contract as hard as I can. Right, so a substitute for an overhead exercise with the dumbbells. You can do it is with the rope. I would usually put the rope, or the cable, sorry, on the lower setting. Bring it up and then allow the cable to take you down, okay? So from here, hands behind your head, it'll automatically pull you into that stretch position and then bring it up and then squeeze at the top. Again, you can be a little bit more, you don't have to be as tidy with this. So if there is a point where you do hit failure, what I would usually do is to extend my set, I'll keep the ropes together and then continue repping it out from here. So if you do hit failure from like here, you might be able to get like 12, and then if you actually keep the ropes together, you should be able to get another, say, 5. Keep the rep range, double digits. So moving to another exercise for your tries. Last one, where you're pulling your hands behind your body, we're gonna go for a double rope cable extension. Here, one reason why I like this exercise is because the amount of range of motion that this gives you. So pulling your elbows into your sides and then pulling the ropes into your chest, okay? If your gym doesn't have a long rope like this, you can either use 2 single ropes and pull it out, or you can actually use the cable and then go for reverse cable extensions. So here, I usually like to keep the rep section quite high, anything between, say, 12 and I'm all the way up to 20 reps. Let's go. Right, so look, a few notes to take away from this. When you're training your arms, first of all, it's important that you vary your angles, so you're hitting different, putting more emphasis on different parts of your arms. Control your weight, make sure you make all of your reps hurt. Learn how to push to failure with whatever rep range that you're doing. Okay, so whether it's sets of 10, you make sure that 10th rep is the last one that you can do. Okay, if it's 20 reps, make sure it's 20 reps and that is it, okay? Once you do that, and then you find that you've hit a wall, then you can focus on maybe increasing the frequency of, increasing how often that you train that muscle, okay? That is pretty much it, guys. Thank you for tuning in. Make sure you like, subscribe, and all that malarkey.